Let's move on to the next reaction. And actually, these next two are going to be both considered partial saturation. So what that means is that for these next two, I'm not saturating all the way to an alkane. In fact, what I'm doing is I'm taking a triple bond and I'm only reacting it to a double bond. So I am adding two hydrogens, but I'm stopping there, okay? And the first of these, the biggest difference between them, other than the reagents, which are totally different, are the stereochemistry. Notice that my first one is anti-addition. Notice that my second one is syn addition. That's gonna have a difference in what my products look like. So let's look at this first one. The first one's called dissolving metal reduction, okay? Dissolving metal reduction is just another name for these reagents. And what it is that we have some kind of metal, lithium or sodium. Your professor can use either one in some kind of liquid amine source. Many times that amine is gonna be NH3, but there's a lot of other things it could be. It could be NH2CH3, or it could be just any kind of usually primary or secondary amine. All right, cool. So we've got that part down. What does it do? Well, we learned, I just taught you guys that partial saturation means that it's only working on triple bonds. So notice that I have the same or a very similar molecule here. And what I'm wondering is, how should I draw this? I have the same sigma framework, but for example, should I draw the double bond or should I leave it there? I should leave it there, because it turns out that since this is partial saturation, it has no effect on alkenes. No effect on alkenes. All right, it's only going to work on triple bonds. So now I've got this triple bond, is it gonna work on this one? Absolutely. Well, what does anti-addition mean? Anti-addition, if you remember, that just means I have trans products, okay? So what that means is that I would expect that my hydrogens are gonna add from different sides of this double bond. What that means is that I should actually draw the double bond in a trans position. Why? Because the two hydrogens that I added must have added on different sides, okay? Of different sides of the double bond, which means that they were anti-addition. Is that making sense? So what that means is that dissolving metal reduction is important because this is a way that we can turn triple bonds into trans double bonds. That's gonna be your product, trans double bonds. Pretty cool, right? So that's something you have to keep in mind because for synthesis later, when we start trying to make molecules, that's gonna be really the only way that we know how to turn a triple bond and make it trans. Cool? So now let's go to this next one, which I'm sure you guys can already kind of anticipate what's gonna happen. Notice that this one's called Lindlar's Catalyst. And Lindlar's Catalyst has a lot of different reagents that you could use. Unfortunately, different textbooks, different professors have their own way of writing it. Some professors are gonna be really easy. They're gonna be like, you know what? F all of these reagents, we're just gonna write Lindlar's, okay? They're gonna put H2 in Lindlar's and you're gonna know that that's Lindlar's. But some professors are gonna use the actual reagents that are in the textbook. So some textbooks have this as the P2 catalyst, okay? So the P2 catalyst is one form of Lindlar's. Another form is actually with lead acetate and quinoline. These are reagents that you just have to recognize that they are Lindlar's. You don't need to know exactly what they look like or draw them or even know the mechanism. But what you do need to know is recognize that these are Lindlar's. These are also, just so you guys know, another term that you may hear is that these are poisoned catalysts, okay? Now what could, catalysts. Wow, okay, sorry guys, spelling isn't my forte. So poison catalysts. What does poisoned mean? What it means is that these catalysts have been created in such a way that they're not gonna reduce all the way, or they're not gonna hydrogenate all the way. Instead, they're going to stop at a given point, okay? And that's why they're called poisoned, all right? So these are three different ways that you could see this reagent. Just be aware of them, okay? Personally, I hope that your professor just writes Lindlar's, but you may see these other two reagents come up, all right? So now let's finally get into the products. What should I draw for my product? Well, what I should draw is that I should still keep that double bond, right? Because whenever you have partial saturation, that means you're gonna have no effect on double bonds. That means the only difference, the only thing that I'm really touching here is the triple bond. So how should I draw it? Well, in this case, I have syn addition, and what syn addition means is that I'm going to get cis products. Okay? So what I would expect is that I have to draw this double bond now in a way that has my R group cis to whatever that double bond is. So I'm going to get out of the way here and draw this for you. I would actually want to draw my stick down this time. Why? Because if I create like a little fence parallel to this double bond, what I see is that now both of my groups are going to be on the same side of that fence. So this creates cis double bonds. All right, so I know that was a lot of reagents. I'm just going to stay here for a little bit so that you guys can write that down. But anyway, I know that seemed like a lot of reagents, but really it's not that bad, especially when you're not having to consider any mechanisms at this point yet. I just want you to know the reagents, recognize what they do, and be able to draw them, okay? Be able to draw the products, all right? And keep in mind the stereochemistry, because the stereochemistry really is the most important part of these reactions. All right, so let's move on to the next topic.